Okay, let's do a pull. Full choke. Key on. 3/4 throttle. Got it. Thanks, Tubes. Excuse me. Thanks, guys. Okay, guys, it's all back together, including the chute control. And it was too bad I had such a hard time getting it running at the right after I finished, but the mixture setting was so far out from the leaking gas valve, or from the leaking exhaust valve, excuse me, that I had to reset the mixture setting before it would run properly. So now, it should start with the row. Just a little tiny bit less than full throttle, or full choke. I'm tired, excuse me. So it should start. You know the way I set these is there's a mid-range, you make it lean till it sputters, and then you go all rich till it sputters with the screw under here under the carburetor, and then you just go on the rich side of smooth on the running of it. So anyway, thanks for watching, guys. I know sometimes when I'm doing stuff and I get going, I hopefully got everything that I needed to film. So thanks a lot. Bye. All right, guys. It's been a couple of days. I guess I better adjust that camera a little bit. Light is one of my struggles. Okay. So, on. Make sure I'm not going to bang myself here. Choke. 90% throttle or so. Now let's see if it starts. I hope it does. Let's go. So that's what a little compression will do for you. It was interesting, just the before this, that when I did the valve grind on the exhaust valve, I had to readjust the carburetor because it was running so differently that it needed a different mixture. And now when it changes temperature, it doesn't change the way it runs. It runs good right from cold right to hot. So that is really, really cool. So thanks for watching this one, guys. Here's a better look at that little guy. So that's my own personal snowblower. I got two. My John Deere and this one. Although they're both Ariens with Tecumseh motors. So what does that say? Thanks for watching this one, guys. It was very satisfying. Well, I was just going over my little snowblower here. And I did not pick this up last fall. But look at that. The shear pin is gone on my the right side, if you're facing forward, tine. So I'm just going to see if I can find the hole and then tap it out. That's it right there. All right. Tough. I don't know, man. Maybe that's not it. Yeah, that is it, because it must be coming out the other side. But that is a tough, tough hammer. But you know, it's a 40-year-old machine, right? Let me get a longer punch. There's snap-on. There we go. Isn't that interesting? Of course, everything to me is interesting. You guys laugh at that. I don't know if this old snowblower is suffering from metal fatigue. There it is, right there. So can you guys see that? You smell that? Right there. Now, I might just happen to have said unit in stock. Looks like a, oh, this is a 1-inch, not a 3/4. Let's just see. I don't know, might not be long enough. Nope, it's not long enough. Shoot. Well, that's too bad. I gotta go shear pin shopping. Are you watching this? I think you are. Hopefully you get to see. Right there. Yeah. We'll take that one out of there. And I need one that has a 1-inch shank, not a 3/4-inch shank. So I guess I'll have to go buy one of these guys. I'll be coming back when that happens. Okay, guys. I've got nice little egg tires on this little snowblower. And you know, they really work good, almost as good as chains. But these ones are tubeless and they have slowest of leaks. So I just squirted it with soapy water and I'm not seeing anything. I didn't expect to, because the leak is, it's over months, not days, right? So I am gonna do what I think is the lazy man's way out, but I don't want to fight with these any longer. And I'm gonna stick some green slime in here. And it says on the green slime instructions that a wheelbarrow tire takes 237 milliliters, which is very, very close to what I have left in the bottom of this. And I have a full one that we'll do the other one with. I know, Bruce Pender using green slime. Shame on you, pal. But hey, we're not working on the space shuttle. It's an old 40-year-old snowblower with tires that I pulled off of one of those screw-behind tillers that were shot. So the instructions are to dump it in with the valve on top, I believe. Yep. And then rotate it for 0.2 of a mile, which is a lot of rotating, right? So I'm not going to do that. But by the time we do both sides, I think 5 or 6 rotations with 25 pounds of air will be lots. Might even just use this new one here for a quick bit. Okay, might as well use the same tube. I'm just going to squirt a tiny bit more in, because it wasn't quite 200 on that one. Good. So this is one of those things that is a do as I say, not as I do. But you know, this stuff works. And yes, the tire guys are going to say, yeah, buddy, but you're not the one taking it off in 5 years. That's true. Okay, let's take it. says inflate tire, so it doesn't say to inflate tire to what. So I take these to 25 pounds. Oh, I'm getting good at guessing that. Good. And I'll just do the other side and then I'll come back. Well, we might as well do this together. So right now I'm right there. So between here and here, let's say 946 to 7, so it's about 200 to here, right? Are you with me? So from here to here would be more than I need, because it's smaller than a lawnmower tire. Lawnmower tire, this is 237, so we'll just do some squirting. Have a look. I think that's about right. They both leak. One leaks more than the other. Then we'll take a quick little walk down the alley. You don't have to watch that. 25 pounds of air. Let's see if we can get that right on again. I think that's a little shy. Ooh, 26. Now I'm shy. Maybe I should have left it. I used these on the little John Deere homemade wagon. I used this green slime and it worked great. So that's it. Now I'm just going to roll it down the alley, down to the end and back, and that's it. So thanks for watching this one, guys. Okay, you're with me. I just did three runs of the alley, and so that should be good enough for that green slime. So now I just need the replacement shear pin. Yes, I put a 5/16 bolt in there right now to hold it. Alright guys, quickly, here is the proper shear bolt. You see it's got the 1-inch shank from mark to mark. Shank. Nope. I have to tap it. That's all right. Here we go. Thanks for watching.